Hey guys, what's up? My name's Ian, and I'm going to be talking to you today about Oracle, probably my favorite Dota 2 hero. This card can be aimed at advanced players. New players still might get something out of this. You're probably going to hear me say a bunch of gibberish and not understand anything that goes on except for the Skrillex up. So, without further ado, I'm going to explain why Oracle is the most wag hero in the whole game, and then how not to feed with him. So, starting with the spells, first ability is Fortune's End. Gathers power into a bolt of scouring energy and wrecks noobs. Level 1. You can immobilize someone for 2.5 seconds. That's 2.5 seconds of someone standing there in the middle of God knows where getting attacked. Okay, that's really overpowered. Second ability, Fate's Edict. You take 50% more damage, you take 100% less magical damage. And you are also unable to attack. So that sounds like a really crap ability. The thing is that you can put this on either yourself early game or an enemy later in the game. So that way, if in the early game some magical asshole's trying to kill you with a bunch of magic and stuff, you can just throw that on. Then later in the game, if you have Carry who has this really huge sword that he's been spending the entire game polishing. Then you throw that on the enemy carry, who's also spent their entire lives polishing his sword. Then one of them can use their sword, the other one can. So it's good. Even better is Purifying Flames. Take magic damage, then heal over time. You can use it on yourself, allies, or enemies, just not creeps. The main thing to note here is that you can use the shield to negate the magic damage you take at first to only get the heal, so it's kind of stupid overpowered. Then what makes him really overpowered is his ultimate. False Promise. You go invisible for 9 seconds, you don't take damage, you don't take healing, and you cannot break this invisibility, no matter what you do. You just can't. You are permanently invisible for 9 seconds. You can be revealed, but you can cast all the spells you want, and you can attack people as many times as you want, and no one's gonna see you. It's great. The only downside is that after the 9 seconds, you take all the damage and you take all the healing, but the healing's doubled, so it's almost like a double-edged sword, except not really, and you just kill everything. Next, I usually like start off with these, build into these, and depending on how the game's going, I'll go into one of these. If the game's going pretty normal, I'll get these two as my core items. If the game's going really well, I'll progress into these. If I have no faith in my team, I'll start getting these because this way I can at least do something for my team, even if they can't hold themselves up together. Then we're doing okay, and I just want to kill things and screw the team. I'll get these. They're not good, but they're at least slightly retarded. It's not like this where you should only do it if your team is completely useless. But anyways, I digress. Now, I'm going to show you how to play Oracle as an MLG. Get ready.
That's right! Get no smoke! Get no smoke!
Wow! Nope.
Are you ready? I'm sorry.
enjoyed that. That's all I have to say about Oracle. If you've never seen this hero played before, or you still have questions about how the game is even played because you're a noob, go to Dota Cinema's video on Oracle. They also have a bunch of videos about the game in general, so if you have no idea what I was talking about, you can go there. That said, you can expect to see me online, poning some scrubs, making maybe making more videos. I'm probably getting invited to play with PFlex because I'm just so swag. Alright, that's all, guys. See you later.